to stay down.
Diet and exercise appear to be the best weapon available in the fight against colon cancer. The disease is the second leading cause of cancer deaths in the U.S. today. Our medical expert, Dr. Kevin Campbell, is here with more on two new studies that will be released next month by the American Society of Clinical Oncology. And Dr. Campbell, tell us about these studies and how including nuts in your diet along with exercising can make a difference.
You know, in a seven-year study, patients successfully treated for stage three colon cancer, meaning that the cancer had spread to some nearby areas, who ate at least 2 ounces of nuts a week had a 42% lower chance of their cancer coming back and a 57% lower risk of dying from the disease. Nearly one in five patients, or about 19%, said they ate at least 2 ounces of nuts a week, and researchers found both a lower risk of the cancer recurrence and overall higher survival rate in that group. In a second study, they found that colon cancer survivors with the highest healthy lifestyle scores, meaning eating right, exercising, maintaining a healthy weight, had a 42% lower risk of death than those with the lower score. Survival improved even more if patients also limited their alcohol consumption. And patients who strictly followed a healthy lifestyle, who did not drink, had a 51% lower chance of dying and a 36% lower chance of cancer recurrence. So it's a pretty big deal.
Yeah, it's very interesting. And is there a specific type of nuts that's more beneficial?
In this study, the researchers found that the most benefit was found in tree nuts, things like Brazil nuts, cashews, pecans, walnuts, pistachios. Peanuts really didn't show a benefit. They're a legume, and they grow under the ground, likely because they have a different biochemical composition. It may be that tree nuts promote decreased inflammation and lower insulin levels, which we know lead to a decreased risk for cancer recurrence in patients.
So what is your take-home message from the findings?
You know, I think it's important to remember that patients should not think of diet and exercise as a replacement for surgery or chemotherapy for cancer, because we know that chemotherapy clearly saves lives in patients who have colon cancer. However, these studies do tell us that exercise and diet can play a significant role in the recovery and prevention of recurrence, and really should be part of an overall treatment plan. I spoke with a gastroenterologist, Dr. Deborah Fisher, over at Duke University, and she said, you know, this just kind of brings it back home. Diet and exercise are very important in maintaining colon health. You know, it may not be just nuts, it may be the whole package.
And it's so interesting when you think about every little thing you can do and how much a difference just a little thing can make.
Absolutely.
All right. Thank you, Dr. Campbell. If you-